Good morning children, welcome back to our maths class. We are discussing the chapter Introduction to Rational Numbers. Okay, and in the last class we have discussed equivalent rational numbers. Today we are going to discuss positive and negative rational numbers. Okay, we have positive and negative integers. Same way we will have positive and negative rational numbers. Okay, here 2/7. 2/7, it is a positive rational number because here 2, the numerator is positive 2 and denominator is 7, positive 7. Here the denominator and numerators, they are positive, therefore it is a positive rational number. And we can take negative 2/7. Here the denominator is positive and the numerator is negative. Okay, here numerator is negative 2 and denominator is positive 7. Numerator and denominator, they are opposite sign. One is positive and another one is negative. Therefore, it is negative rational number. Negative rational number. Okay, and we can take one more example, negative 2 and negative 7. Listen, here negative 2/-7, both the numerator and denominator, they are negative. Okay, and if there is anything common in the numerator and denominator, we can cancel it. Here negative sign, they are common. Here we have a negative 2 and here also. Okay, negative is common. So we can cancel out that. So negative and negative. Okay, so it is equal to 2/7. So if the numerator and denominator is negative, the rational number will be positive. Okay, so if the denominator and numerator is positive, it is a positive rational number. And if the numerator and denominator, they are negative, then also the rational number will be positive. So we can say that if the numerator and denominator are of same sign, that will be positive rational number. And we can take one more example, 2/-7. 2/-7. Here 2 is positive, numerator is positive and denominator, it is negative 7. Numerator and denominator are of different sign. Therefore, this will be negative rational number. Okay, so if the numerator or denominator is negative, that will be a negative rational number. And if the numerator and denominator is positive, then it is positive rational number. And if the numerator and denominator is negative, then also that will be a positive rational number. Okay, we can check some examples. Here one rational number 3/14. Is it positive or negative? It is positive because numerator and denominator positive, therefore it is positive rational number. Okay, then one more example, 6/-18. Here, numerator is positive and denominator is negative. Therefore, it is negative rational number. Negative rational number. And another example, negative 72 by negative 108. Numerator is negative and denominator also negative. Therefore, it is positive rational numbers. Because here numerator is negative and denominator also negative. So, we can written as 72 by 108. Okay. Then we know standard form of a fraction. What is standard form of a fraction? Suppose we have a fraction 4/6. Is it in the standard form? Here 4/6. Is it in the standard form? No, because here there is common factor for the numerator and denominator. Okay, here 4/6. We need to change them in the least form or standard form. How can we change them into standard form? Here we have something common in the numerator and denominator. Which is common in the numerator and denominator? Here 4, it is a multiple of 2, and 6, it is another multiple of 2. So we can remove that common factor. That is 4/2 and here 6/2, which is equal to 4/2 is 2 and 6/2 is 3, 2/3. And in this 2 and 3, is there any common factor other than 1? No, there is no common factors. So we can say that 2/3. It is the standard form of 4/6. Okay, so to get the standard form, we have to remove the common factors. And when we are removing the common factors, better to remove the highest common factor. Highest common factor means HCF. Okay, so same way we can write the standard form of rational numbers also. Okay, so to write the standard form of a rational number, we can remove the common factors, highest common factors from the numerator and denominator. Suppose it is negative 4/6. What will be the standard form? Here 2 is common, so negative 2/3. Okay, standard form of negative 4/6 is 2/3. Okay, negative 2/3. And suppose we have a rational number negative 12/-16. We need to write the standard form of negative 12/-16. First, we need to check they are in the standard form or not. Okay, here 12/16. Are they in standard form? No, because there is common factor for 12 and 16. Okay, if we can't find the HCF, we can remove the common factors. Okay, anyway, we can remove. No need to find the HCF always. Okay. So, we can find is there any common factor in 12 and 16. Here these two are even numbers. Then there will be a common factor, that is 2. Okay. Then first we can remove that common factor. Before that, the numerator and denominator, they are negative. So, this will be a positive rational number. That is 12/16. Okay, then we can remove the common factors. then 2 divided by 2, then 12 divided by 2 is 6, and 16 divided by 2 is 8, then 6 by 8. Okay, then 6 by 8, is there any common factor? They are also even numbers. Okay, then again 2 will be 6 divided by 2, 8 divided by 2. Okay, then 6 divided by 2 is 3, 3 by 4. Okay, so the standard form of 3 by 4 is 6 by, sorry, the standard form of 6 by 8 is 3 by 4. Okay, so that's why we can find the standard form of a rational number. And we have one more case. Suppose it is 12 by negative 18. 12 by negative. Here, 12 is positive and negative 18 is negative. Okay, numerator is positive and denominator is negative. Okay, then if we are finding the standard form of a rational number, first we have to remove the negative sign from the denominator. Okay, here denominator is negative and we need to write this rational number in the standard form. So our first step is we have to remove this negative sign from the denominator. Okay, how can we remove? To remove this negative sign, we need to multiply with a negative 1. Okay, negative 18 into negative 1 is negative 18 into negative 1 is 18. Okay, so to remove this negative sign, we need to multiply with negative 1. And we have one more condition, that is, if we are doing any operation in the denominator, we have to do the same in the numerator also. Okay, so 12 by negative 18, in the denominator we need to multiply with negative 1. So in the numerator also we have to multiply with negative 1. Okay, then this will be negative 12 by 18. Okay, then we can remove the common factors. Which is the common factor? Here 2 is a common factor, so we can first remove that one. Okay, if we can't find the HCF, we can remove the factors like that. Okay, then 12 by 18, 12 divided by 2 and 18 divided by 2. 12 divided by 2 is, here it is negative 12. So negative 12 divided by 2 is negative 6. And 18 divided by 2 is 9. Okay, then it is negative 6 by 9. 3 is a common factor, 6 and 9. So divided by 3 and divided by 3. So it is negative 2 by 3. Or otherwise 12, which is the HCF of 12 and 18? It is 6. Okay. So 2 into 6 is 12 and 3 into 6 is 18. HCF. We can remove directly the HCF also. Okay. So if the denominator is negative, we need to convert that denominator into positive. Okay, how can we change the denominator into positive? We can multiply with a negative 1. If you are multiplying the denominator by negative 1, we have to multiply numerator also by negative 1. Okay, so today we have discussed positive and negative rational numbers and standard form of a rational number. Okay, and next class onwards we can solve some problems. Okay, you have to practice this. That's all for today. Thank you.